For this lesson, you need to open the sample file, The Wealth of Nations, from your Sample Files folder. When you're editing a workbook, the changes you make are only held in the computer's memory. If there's a power cut or your computer crashes, you will lose any work that's been done since the last save. For this reason, you should get into the habit of regularly saving your work. Even though we haven't changed this worksheet, let's save it now by clicking the Save button on the Quick Access toolbar. The Quick Access toolbar is the group of icons at the top left of your screen. And the icon that looks like an old-fashioned floppy disk is the Save icon. I click Save, and the workbook is saved. Now let's do something that's slightly different. We'll save the workbook, but this time with a different name. So I'm going to click the File button at the top left of the screen, and then click Save As in the left-hand list. Notice that I can save to my computer or to MikeSmart's OneDrive. A OneDrive can be thought of as a disk drive in the sky. It's just like the hard drive on your computer, but it exists on a Microsoft server many miles away, accessed via the internet. The OneDrive can be very useful when you need to access your files from several different computers. A OneDrive also provides an easier way to share files with other people. The OneDrive is part of a completely new way of working called cloud computing. Support for cloud computing is by far the most important new feature of Excel 2013. Because cloud computing is such an involved and complex subject, I've devoted an entire session to it in Session 8, Cloud Computing. I advise you not to jump ahead to the last session at this stage in your learning, as the session will be difficult to understand until you've completed the earlier sessions. So for the moment, we'll focus on saving files to the computer's hard drive. So I click on Computer, and then I'll click the Browse button to find a location on the hard drive to save the file. The dialog you're seeing now will appear if you're using Windows 8. It might be slightly different for Windows 7 users, but you should easily be able to figure out the difference. Now let's click the drop-down arrow to the right of the Save As Type drop-down list. A list appears showing a large number of different file formats. Most of the time, you'll want to use the default format, Excel Workbook. But there may be times when you'll need to save in one of the other formats. You'll learn all about the most important formats, and when you should use them, in the next lesson. For now, we'll stay with the default Excel Workbook format. So I'll click Excel Workbook. Now I want to change the file name so that it's different. I'll click in the File Name box, and I'll press the right arrow key to take away the highlight from the existing file name, then the space bar, and I'll type the word copy. Now I'm going to click the Save button. Notice that the name of the workbook in the title bar at the top of the window has now changed, indicating that you're now viewing the new workbook that you've just saved, The Wealth of Nations Copy. And you've now completed Lesson 1-6, Save a Workbook to a Local File.